According to the Moro District LOC 5 chairperson, Okello Douglas Peter Okawo, President Yoweri Museveni has pledged 2.2 billion shillings for the completion of the double-storied building in time.
I want to confirm that there is a commitment from the head of state, the president, that the house that the late Jacob Olanya started constructing be completed by the state. And as the local organizing committee chairman and the chairman of Moro District, and on behalf of the clan and the family, we are grateful for this good gestures of the president.
The gesture is in response to the requests from his family and the Acholi people who want Jacob Olanya's legacy to remain alive.
We shall respect the vision, the wish of the family, of the clan, so that the body of the late spends a night in his own house. And as I talk right now, you've seen for yourselves that they're putting tiles on the building and many other work is ongoing on the site.
Construction is being spearheaded by the UPDF Engineering Brigade and is estimated at 55%. The vision of the former Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanya, was to see his house completed within this year, as the locals also benefit from his bricklaying project to upgrade from grey-thatched houses to modern and permanent houses.
As we celebrate the life of former Speaker Jacob Olanya, today I am walking in front of this warehouse where he started a bricklaying project to help the community here elevate themselves from grey-thatched houses to a simple modern house.
Odoki Silvesto is a teacher at Ajuri Primary School. In 2019, the former Speaker of Parliament constructed for him a house using mortar bricks.
He constructed them for the teachers who are now accommodating the houses. And is assisting the teachers who come from afar to stay within the school compound so that they maintain the punctuality of the school.
The houses provide a safer environment for the families.
They are strong houses. We don't fear sleeping here because it is safe. You can see he made them with the steel doors, steel windows, and there's nothing like fear or insecurity.
The bricks are currently lying in big heaps as there is uncertainty of who will carry forward this community transforming project.
These bricks we are seeing behind me was one of this man's biggest agenda to support the community. His biggest agenda. His emphasis was, let Omoro people elevate from being in a grass touch house. They get to Mabati house. That was his dreams. And why he was building this big country home, he really wanted to engage himself fully in this term. Ground himself in Omoro, in a logi. That he now start chasing away poverty.
Jacob Olanya is commonly known as Dano Padano in Omoro district, which loosely translated means a people's person. He is also remembered for leading the carving out of Omoro district from Gulu. By the time of his death on the 20th of March, he was in advanced plans of installing the very first radio station in Omoro district.
He was looking at job creation to the people who are jobless in this country. Two, he was looking at the development, because Gulu city, Gulu town was too far away from Odek, Lalogi, Lakwana. It was too far away. So, for development to come very close to the people, needed a town. A very big town, well planned, designed, and in the policy of the government.
The body of Jacob Olanya is expected in the country on Friday, the 1st of April, 2022. All houses at the ancestral home in Ajuri village are being renovated. The local burial organizing committee chairperson, Okello Douglas Peter Okawo, is calling on the public to join the inter-denominational prayers being held every day at 1 p.m.
The populations are free to access this place. We have also strengthened intelligence within the home and the surrounding places so that if there are individual persons who wants to cause problems, we are able to have that information and respond, because As you are aware, the threats of terrorism is high in this country.
A descendant of the Okaruwok Yetole clan, Jacob Olanya loved traditional dances. Acholi traditional Bola and Otole dances will be performed all throughout the activities, leading to the burial of the former Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanya.
Renowned for his cultural beliefs, former Speaker of Parliament Jacob Olanya did not only stop at supporting families rise from grass-thatched houses, he also extended his generosity to the church. Joseph Omagor, The News.